Professor David, you are calling for a circuit breaker. What exactly does that mean?
Well, it's a circuit breaker lockdown, similar to what they use in other countries like Singapore. So they use it as a parang preemptive strike this sa pandemic. It's essentially like a lockdown. Yun yung term nila. So to basically, cut off transmission of the virus. What we noticed kasi is the numbers are still rising in the NCR, even though GCQ with heightened restrictions. We're waiting for it to slow down. Right now, we're not seeing yet a slowdown. Yung reproduction numbers sa NCR, it's 1.33. So medyo tumataas pa siya, though not as fast as it would. And the reason is, we have sufficient vaccinations naman sa NCR. From what I'm hearing, at least 20% fully vaccinated. Some are saying baka umabot na 30%. And
NCR. This is NCR.
NCR, yes. And that's a significant effect this sa trend natin. But the cases are still rising. Kasi based on my calculation, so pag 20% fully vaccinated, sabi natin, we can even add to that yung mga nagka-COVID na, because based on the research, those who have had COVID already are, yung level of protection nila is equivalent to those with full vaccination. So looking at that, it's still rising, even though may sufficient level of vaccination. So we hope na, yes.
Professor, ang proposal niyo is a hard lockdown for 2 weeks. What does hard lockdown mean exactly? Is that ECQ as we knew it nung start ng pandemic? Lockdown.
Pwedeng ECQ, pwedeng MECQ, but something more strict than what we have right now in GCQ with heightened restrictions. So maybe.
But sir, would it be stricter than what we had nung March and April, when we had a surge? What do you have in mind?
Well, pwede, but pwedeng hindi, because we can compare two timelines, no? Just to illustrate. Last year, nung August, July, we were having a surge, and then we had an MECQ when we reached about 2,000 cases in the NCR, 2,000 cases in the NCR. MECQ for 2 weeks, it was able to get the job done. 2 weeks lang. Because the level of cases was lower. Nasa 2,000 cases lang tayo. In fact, we instituted the MECQ siguro slightly below 2,000 as we were approaching 2,000 cases.
This was in August, sir? Tama ba? This was last year when we gave a break for the medical workers.
Yes. MECQ, 2-week MECQ timeout. Nung March this year, we were already at around 4 to 5,000 cases. Nag-peak tayo 5,000 cases per day. So yung ECQ natin lasted longer. ECQ plus MECQ, I think lasted 5 or 6 weeks. Mm-hmm. So it was longer kasi the caseload was already higher. Mm-hmm. And those 6 weeks will have more of an economic impact than yung 2 weeks. I mean, yeah. It makes sense, di ba? I mean, which would you rather have, 6 weeks? I mean, of course, if you're involved with the business, you might rather have no ECQ at all. Pero yun nga, what we're seeing is that it's currently not yet working. So maybe it's inevitable din naman. So why not get it done with na 2 weeks? Since our caseload now in NCR is around 1,000 cases per day, bago pa tayo umabot ng 2,000, maybe even 1 week we'll do it. Kasi if it's a hard lockdown, baka mapababa
pero
na.
Pero dapat now na. Ganun ba yun?
Delaying it
sooner, the better. Yeah.
Yeah, delaying it will just make the problem bigger until, but if you fix it now, you're fixing a smaller hole. Whereas if you make the hole bigger, then it's more difficult to patch it up.
Well, actually, nagre-reverse yung iba because it's Delta and there are so many breakthrough infections. Diba? So yan ang problema. This is Delta.
Yeah, well, we don't have data sa breakthrough infections sa Philippines. I haven't seen it yet. Pero in other countries, we hear about breakthrough infections. Pero What I read about in other countries, yung level of breakthrough infections naman is lower, syempre, and they're usually not ano, the severe cases. So so I think we could manage with vaccinated people. And by the way, right now, Cebu City, I just checked the numbers. They had 375 new cases. It's a record for them. This is the highest they've ever gotten in one day, 375 in one day. So, you know, I think they're having a major surge there. They need to address that as well. You know, Cebu, Lapu-Lapu as well. And that's the reproduction number nila. It's 2. So, you know, it's not going to stop. It's 2. Wow. Oh, it's already at 2. It's probably probably worse than their surge already. I mean, I haven't seen any genome sequencing for Cebu City yet, but my impression is this much, there's a Delta strong possibility in Delta. Because ang bilis eh. And then yun nga, sa NCR, it's 1.33. We're not yet, you know, in the worst situation, pero ang sinasabi nga natin, we can do a preemptive strike bago. I mean, look at Cebu City. Just a week or two ago, they were, you could say na, okay pa naman Cebu City eh, but you know, because you waited too long, suddenly you have this.
Professor, speaking of waiting too long, we only have time for one more quick question with you. But just going back to Lucci's point, give us an idea of how much each day matters now. I mean, when you say that, you know, the sooner the better. But in terms of your modeling, how much does each day actually matter?
Well, each day actually matters. I mean, of course, girl, just one single day might not be such a, you know, might not make a big difference. But you know, waiting like 1 week delay could be big problems because the caseload could almost double in a span of 1 week, and especially since we're starting to see young. Yung increase in the NCR starting to accelerate. So ibig sabihin, you know, maybe it wasn't doubling the past few weeks, pero you know, right now we have 1,000 cases. Last week, 700. So that's already 300 and a dagdag. You know, in a matter of 1 week, we could already be at around 1,500. It's more difficult to control 1,500 compared to 1,000, as I'm sure you will agree.
Okay.